This is Dr. Clark from the Center for Weight Loss Success, and this is the Weight Loss Question of the Week. And I've been asked recently to discuss a little bit about raspberry ketones. You hear all about them in the media these days. They've been on Dr. Oz. A lot of people question it. And so let's have just a quick discussion on raspberry ketones. Raspberry ketones have actually been around for a long period of time. They were considered, basically they were approved by the FDA in 1965 as being generally regarded as safe. And so they're used in perfume, they're used in cosmetics, they're used as food additives. They have this nice fruity odor to them, and so they can make kind of other chemicals seem even nicer. So they're used in lots of different things. But now they're kind of being considered, it could be helpful in weight loss. Now, the reason this somewhat came around is because the raspberry ketones are structurally similar to a compound called synephrine. And synephrine is used in a lot of different over-the-counter weight loss diet pills. And synephrine is used because ephedrine was taken off the market here a few years ago, because ephedrine had a number of the health problems related to it. Ephedrine taken off the market, subsequently then synephrine is introduced. Well, raspberry ketones have an appearance, structural appearance, that are similar to synephrine. So in theory, it can increase your metabolism. Cell cultures too, it's also been shown that they may increase a hormone called adiponectin. And adiponectin actually is involved in lipid and glucose metabolism, and it also helps kind of affect our body weight. Unfortunately, there hasn't been a whole lot studied here. There are no human studies on raspberry ketones. There are a couple animal studies. One of the animal studies that's usually quoted is there's a mouse study. And it actually was that mice were given like 5,000 times a normal human dose, and it seemed to prevent weight gain. Okay, it wasn't that it really stimulated weight loss, but it prevented weight gain in these overfed mice. And then also, again, there have been cultures and in petri dishes, so to speak, that in fat cells, they're shown to increase fatty acid oxidation. So, kind of, we don't know whether they're really safe for humans. Again, they're not. There aren't any human studies, but in theory, it can help affect body weight. It can affect and subsequently increase your metabolism a little bit. Now, since it is kind of the structure similar to synephrine, it also has some potential cardiovascular risk to it. So we don't really know. Is it really safe? There aren't a whole lot of studies, but my feeling on that is that potentially it can be helpful if you're doing all the other right things. And you need to be doing all the right things. If you think you're going to take raspberry ketones and lose a lot of weight, I think you're very mistaken. Now, if you're doing all the right things, good diet, good activity, exercise plan, and then potentially raspberry ketones could help, as long as you're not having any heart problems and you don't have a history of heart problems, it's probably a safe thing to try. So, if you want to try it, try it. Let the buyer beware. Anyway, that's my opinion on raspberry ketones. If you have other questions, though, again, let us know. One of these days, we're going to talk a little bit about HCG. That may be coming up in the next couple of weeks. Keep your eye out. We'll see you at the office. You take care.